Thank you for joining Pioneer Library System. I'm Lauren, Team Librarian.
And I'm Chris, Steam Specialist.
Today, we're making chocolate chip cookies. Delicious chocolate chip cookies.
Also, terrible chocolate chip cookies.
Terrible chocolate chip cookies? There is no such thing.
Oh, there is.
Okay, well, what kind of chocolate chip cookies do you like?
I like them chewy with lots of chips. What about you?
Ooh, I love gooey cookies that fall apart when you pick them up. I also like big, gooey, chewy, soft, dense, lumpy, chocolatey, buttery, thick, golden brown.
All the adjectives. But have you ever thought about how the ingredients you put into a cookie affect the adjectives that come out? Like, how do you make a cookie crispier? What do all those ingredients do?
That's a good question. Let's find out. We found a lot of chocolate chip cookie recipes here at the library. The recipes have some differences in their ingredients.
One of the things that changes is the various amounts of baking soda and baking powder in the recipes. But what are baking soda and baking powder?
The ingredients list on baking soda says baking soda. Right. Well, its scientific name is sodium bicarbonate. It's a base which reacts with the acid in brown sugar to make your cookies rise, like that volcano science fair experiment.
Baking powder is a combination of baking soda plus its own acid. So if you replace the baking soda with an equal amount of baking powder, you're decreasing the amount of base and increasing the amount of acid. That'll change the taste a little, but it'll make the cookie rise differently too.
Acid? Cool flesh-eating cookies!
Not that much acid, Lauren.
Lame. Whatever. Let's bake. Our main ingredients are flour and salt. Then for our experiment, we have three variations.
Our control is the classic Toll House recipe, which calls for just baking soda.
In our second batch, we'll use an equivalent amount of baking powder. We'll call this batch the Flesh Eaters.
Lauren.
Fine testing.
And for the third batch, we'll start with the balanced recipe and then add extra baking powder. That's test B.
These look good. Which ones are the flesh eaters?
Let's find out.
It's a little cakier.
I wouldn't have described my perfect chocolate chip cookie as cakey, but I'm really into it, so.
A little crunchier than I like.
See, it's just a little too crunchy for me.
It might be a little crunchier than the rest, but honestly, I don't mind.
I don't find huge differences between them.
This one's a lot chewier than I thought it was going to be.
This one has a nice crunch.
The classic recipe makes a cookie that looks like this. Compared to that, the cookies from test A,
the flesh eaters,
the one with baking powder replacing the baking soda, were a little flatter and crispier. Not a huge difference, just a little bit.
No flesh was eaten, sadly. Test B,
the ones with the normal recipe amount of baking soda plus extra baking powder added,
gave cookies that rose more and were cakier and paler. But surprisingly, there wasn't as much difference as we expected.
Yeah, so you're free to experiment with the amounts of baking soda and baking powder to create your favorite cookie.
Well, we didn't actually kill anyone.
But we did get one step closer to making killer cookies. And of course, one of the most important ingredients for a good-tasting chocolate chip cookie is the chocolate chips. Check out the new taste testing series, Taste Buddies, to see which chocolate chips librarians prefer.
Next time, we'll test the difference between granulated and brown sugar.
See you then!